In most of the cases, rhinoplasty will be associated with a septal correction also. So the first one we need is freer elevator. So this is one-sided nasal elevator used for elevating the flap. So the subperichondrial or subperiosteal elevation of the mucosa and detachment of bony and cartilaginous septum. So freer elevator. If there is turbinate hypertrophy, especially the inferior turbinate hypertrophy causing or affecting the nasal valve area, we have to do surgery of nasal turbinate along with a rhinoplasty. So that is optional, and this is nasal turbinectomy scissors, Formont's nasal turbinectomy scissors. You can see the tip of that scissors, angled one for turbinectomy. The must needed instrument for rhinoplasty is different types of retractors. This retractor is highly protective, and the long lateral blades, it retract the soft tissue, and also it improves the visibility. Especially this will retract the smass after elevating the flap. These two, though look similar, there are small differences. This one is a Kilner hook cum ALR retractor, and you can see the tip of it is little bit blunt so that it is protective, and this one is a small ALR hook. This is used to retract the skin and cartilage during dissection of nasal ALR, and this small ALR hook, the tip is much more pointed. There is chance of damage, so you should be more careful. And this one is a blunt tip, the Kilner hook cum ALR retractor. This is retractor cum hook. Okay, this is again used to one end for retracting the soft tissue, and this is for hooking the ALR, especially the ALR skin. Metzenbaum super cut scissors. This is used to cut the tissue and the suture materials. It has got a long handle, so this will permit to work in the deep tissue. And this scissor blades are wide opening also. The scissor blades are wide opening, so it is very easy to work in deeper tissue without affecting our visibility. This one is curved tip, but straight tips are also available. Okay, so Metzenbaum supercut scissors. This is osteotome, and the tip is 3 mm micro osteotome. Look at the tip of this, and usually the residents confuse this with a chisel. So for an osteotome, the end is like this. Okay, on anteroposteriorly, even if it look like this, the side view will be like this. Okay, whereas this one is a chisel, so caudal chisel, and for a chisel, the end will be like this. Okay, whereas for an osteotome, it will be like this. On both side will be pointed, and for the chisel, it is like this. So you should look at the tip of it. Okay, so this one is chisel and this one is an osteotome, and in both one the one end look will be like this only, but lateral view will be entirely different. So that you should be very careful while identifying the instrument. Okay. And this chisel provide an extremely flat cutting edge. Okay, and the set osteotomy level is continuously retained, leading to very precise detachment. So 3 mm osteotome, and this one is a chisel, and the chisel can be straight or curved ending. In either case, you have to identify it by looking at the tip of it. Both are chisel. See the tip of it. This is skin hook. It's a single hook. And that is Kilner-Gillis hook. And if it is double hook, sometime the hook will be, there will be two hook. Like this. Instead of the single hook like this, there will be double hook. And if it is double hook, it is usually called the Joseph hook. Micro Edson Cocker forceps with teeth and without teeth. Both are used for handling very delicate issues during the rhinoplasty surgery. Here, see the teeth. At the tip of it, there is a teeth, and this one is Edson forceps without teeth. This is a wire and a bone cutter. See the double action plier. Sometime this is used in rhinoplasty too to remove the bone projections. Guided osteotome for extra protection. See at the tip there is a guide for right side and left side separately. So this is actually protective. Okay, so this one here, see the guide, so it will not go beyond the specific length, so gives protection while doing the osteotomy. So guided osteotomes for rasping the hump, nasal hump. Different types of rasp are there. See the tip of it. So different types of rasp are there. And for glabella rasp, for rasping the glabella area, it is actually a curved one. So glabella rasp are like this. It is curved rasp. All other part, this will be straight. All other rasp, this will be straight. Except the glabella rasp, which is glabella rasp will be curved one. All other rasp, the rasping surface will be straight. These are some of the instruments which are specific for rhinoplasty. There are so many other instruments, like so many different type of scissors, elevators. But this instrument, especially the Offrisch retractor, is usually asked in OSCEs and also in VIVA.